Anxiety Hacks Part 2 Refuel with Dr. Scott Monk. Last time we talked about the 8 R's. Number 1 was refuel. What I said was to eat 3 protein meals per day, no skipping. The reason why we want to do this is because blood sugar instability is one of the major concerns with anxiety and adrenaline dominance, as is whole body inflammation where your joints, your gut, your brain is all on fire. More specifics with blood sugar instability, you might feel shaky, lightheaded, have mood changes with missed meals. Perhaps you get dizzy or lightheaded when getting up from a chair or from getting up from tying your shoes. Maybe you're not hungry in the morning, or perhaps you have nausea. Your stomach might even be upset in the morning. You use coffee to jumpstart your day because you have a lack of energy. Morning headaches are common, as is fatigue after heavy carbohydrate meals. Basically, blood sugar instability is a form of cellular starvation where your cells themselves are simply not getting enough of the fuel they need and the nutrients they need to function properly. Eventually, that leads to cellular inflammation, what we call cells on fire. Whole body inflammation, on the other hand, is basically in 2 categories. You can have inflammation in the gut, leads to things like pain in the digestive tract, GI bloating, for example, perhaps heartburn or acid reflux. Lots of patients complain of constipation or regular loose stools. Food intolerances or food allergies are also extremely common when the gut is inflamed. Inflammation in the body is more like pain in the joints or muscles, perhaps even brain fog or unclear thinking. Lots of times inflammation in the body shows up as skin rashes, acne, or hives. So is there a diet that can help? Yes, there is. It's called the Gentle GI Diet. The Gentle GI Diet is designed to help restore the body's systems most impacted by adrenaline dominance and, in our topic today, anxiety. The Gentle GI Diet was originally designed to help those with severe digestive issues like IBS, Crohn's disease, or gastroparesis. However, all people who are experiencing any level of anxiety or fight or flight will see significant benefits by using the Gentle GI Diet. This Gentle GI Diet relies on soft, cooked foods and plenty of protein. Soft foods allow the irritated linings of the entire digestive tract to heal and allows the stomach to take a break. Whereas the protein eaten at each meal regulates blood sugar swings and any related hormonal imbalances, and there are always hormonal imbalances with blood sugar problems. All these positive changes promote an easy and natural detoxification while reducing whole body inflammation. Here are the details of the Gentle GI Diet. If this was a plate, 1/4 of your plate should be protein. 1/4 should be your favorite starch or carb, and 1/2 of your plate should be cooked vegetables. Examples of proteins are things like nut butters, not whole handfuls of nuts as we'll talk about shortly, meats, fish, or beans. Your starch or carb could be things like rice, bread, potato, or quinoa. This isn't a gluten-free diet, so bread is still on the menu. Cooked vegetables, how about some green beans, asparagus, broccoli, or spinach? I know most of you may not like these things, but you need to learn to eat them regularly because they are so medicinally beneficial to your body. They're healthy. Well, what do I avoid? Avoid these, all abrasive foods, things like salads, all lettuces, kale, and spinach in their raw form. Don't eat a bunch of raw broccoli or raw celery or other raw crunchy vegetables when you're on the Gentle GI Diet. Seeds can be abrasive. Popcorn or corn chips are abrasive. Granola, dried fruit, yes, cereal. People live off of cereal. Cereal is one of the worst foods for you, as we'll discuss in the next video. Handfuls of nuts need to be avoided, although certain nut butters are acceptable. The nuts themselves are too abrasive for the digestive tract during this 3-week period of time. Also avoid all cow milk-based products and all plant milk-based products if the plant milk-based product has a calcium carbonate level above 10%. What is calcium carbonate? It's one of the most important minerals that's added to foods that we need to discuss. Calcium carbonate is limestone or chalk. It's what's used in Tums or Rolaids as an antacid. It's an alkalizer. It breaks down acid in the stomach. It's an inexpensive mineral used to make a food seem good for you because they like to put a nice label on the outside of their products that says, hey, we've got 50% more calcium than milk. We're good. Well, if you can't absorb the calcium, or if that calcium's becoming bound up in your body and causing muscle contractions, spasms, or kidney stones, then you really don't want that calcium. But often it makes things worse long-term, as I have found regularly with my patients. Calcium carbonate reduces stomach acid. Low stomach acid leads to poor digestion of proteins and poor absorption of minerals, the exact things we need to have happen to calm down the fight-or-flight response, reduce anxiety, and heal our gut. This also means do not drink alkalizing waters that are so popular these days. They too reduce the acid in your stomach, which is the opposite thing we need to have happen. When you're under stress, you have chronic fight or flight or anxiety, stomach acid in the long term reduces, and you lose the ability to digest your food properly. So do not alkalize it further. What if I do not have any digestive issues? Patients always ask me. The Gentle GI Diet was originally designed to help those with severe digestive issues like IBS, Crohn's disease, or gastroparesis, as I mentioned earlier, and many of my patients don't have that, and hopefully you don't either. So many of you probably could do a modified version of this diet and eat a salad or two a week. I call that the 75% Gentle GI Diet. But don't. You do have anxiety, you do have adrenaline dominance, you have lots of symptoms that indicate that your body is in a fight or flight situation. You know your body needs help, so let's not take any shortcuts. Do the full Gentle GI Diet for 3 weeks and give your body the best chance to heal itself in the most efficient manner possible. That's all for this video, but in the next video I'm going to discuss the specifics of what to eat, how to eat, and why some of your favorite foods like milk and chocolate are harmful for you. So be sure to subscribe at Health Makes Sense on YouTube, or go to drscottmonk.com for more information, or to pick up a copy of my book, Balanced. I will see you at the next video.